favorite childhood Disney movie, The Little Mermaid, Ariel grabs Flounder and says, "Don't be such a little guppy." Now, some of you may be thinking the same thing with me. Now, David, don't be such a little guppy. It's Disney. I mean, Disney's good, right? And so what I'm here to tell you today is that at some point, we've all watched Disney Channel. We've had some kind of interaction with it at some point in our life. And now that we're in college, babysitting is a prime time gig. All right? And so I've been watching Disney ever since I was a little kid as well. When we'd go to the hotel, my parents would sit us down and say, the only show you're allowed to watch is Disney Channel. And so it's not uncommon for us to be exposed to Disney more frequently than we think. And so I'm David Dempsey. I'm a freshman here at Rockhurst University. And my purpose today is to persuade you that the Disney Channel influences children to be disrespectful. And we'll do this through evaluating some episode clips and some parent testimonials, as well as looking at the neurological effects on the adolescent brain that Disney has, and finally looking at some of the solutions that we can go about. So first we're going to look at an episode from Liv and Maddie, which is a Disney television show.
Well, I failed. I guess I know what it feels like to be a loser now. And you know what I'm talking about, Joey.
Ouch. I would call that a drive-by if you had your license.
Now notice what's present here. She comes in and expresses the fact that she's sad that she didn't get her license. Looking at her brother, she pulls in a direct attack towards him, saying, well, you're a loser too. What do we hear? We hear laughter. We don't hear the parents actually stepping in like they would in any kind of regular household argument between siblings. So pulled back, he thinks to himself and comes back with another witty comment, directly firing back at her. Again, is supported by this canned laughter that isn't actually realistic in any way, shape, or form. Another clip from the TV show Ant Farm represents this again.
You wanted to see me?
No.
We wanted to talk to you. No one wants to see you. Ew. Principal Skidmore.
Now, China walks up to the lady and addresses her as Principal Skidmore, emphasizing the fact that this is, in fact, the principal of whom we're talking to. Again, it's supported by this canned laughter that makes it seem to children that it's okay to disrespect an adult or an authority figure in this way. Nikki Elliott is a mother of two children and emphasizes this point in her YouTube video, Why Disney Drives Us Crazy. She highlights the video that we just saw from Liv and Maddie, which was uploaded May 2014, and talks about, well, I was in my house doing chores and I heard laughter in the background. Went on to another chore and again, heard more laughter in the background. Finally, just getting so fed up with Disney Channel, I turned it off and decided to look at a specific video and see how much laughter is really in Disney Channel. So the Liv and Maddie episode that we just looked at runs about 21 minutes without commercials. The video that she uploads to YouTube that is only the laughter in the background is 7 minutes. That means that what we're watching in Disney Channel, 1/3 of it is this canned laughter. And so you may be thinking to yourself, well, I know that I'm not going to walk up to one of my professors and say, no one wants to see you. Ew. Because we have the logical processing to not do that. But when we look to a mom that wrote into Balance Edutainment, which is a children's company that balances education and entertainment, she wrote about how her children were watching Disney Channel and soon started getting the sass and this hair flipping action that just wasn't normal for them. And so with this, she wrote into this company and said, can you please explain this? They wrote back to her July 2014, and the article is Disney Really Ruining Her Kid? A Neurological Perspective. So entering into our teen years, the brain is insulating nerve fibers with a substance called myelin. This is a protein phospholipid substance that is working through the brain, and the frontal lobe region is the last place of the brain to be insulated. This means that emotional maturity and preteens is the last thing that is developed in our brain. Now, this may not seem like a significant portion, but when we're looking at how much canned laughter is being inserted into these Disney shows, we see just how much these kids are encouraged that this kind of laughter is funny. Because everybody likes to laugh. Laughing feels good. And so with this good feeling, they're encouraged that this is the normal thing of how people actually conversate with each other. And so what's prevented from actually developing properly is logical thought. We can look at those clips and laugh to ourselves and say, I would never actually do that to anyone. But that's logical thought. We've already gone through the process of developing that. The personal empathy is seen in the Liv and Maddie episode where we see her actually discourage personal empathy by pulling him aside and say, you're a loser, where we're not actually empathizing with anyone. The maturity in speech is also unable to develop because we don't realize it's really not okay to go up to your principal and say that. I don't recommend ever trying that. And finally is the sensory capabilities, which perhaps may be the most important part of this adolescent brain development. What this is that the five senses that we have, six if you're perhaps so lucky, is that when the senses are activated and those are interpreted, then what we see is the actions and the behaviors that we deem okay from that is what is result of our sensory capabilities. And so when we hear this laughter, we think, well, you know, that's what's encouraged, that's what's right. And so when we perceive the things as being acceptable and okay, we realize just how negatively and devastating this actually is. Meg Pullen in her blog, Meg Pullen Indeed, writes in April 2014, Disney is ruining my kid, retrieved December 4th. She talks about the winter break that the kids just experienced, and then going back the next semester, was astonished to find that her daughter was pulled into the principal's office for inappropriate behavior and talking back. She sat down with her daughter and said, what is going on with you? Only to find out that it was Disney Channel that was responsible for the actions that she was doing in school. So there's a direct correlation between what we experience on Disney Channel, happening in our schools, and happening in the households with kids. And so some of the solutions that we can take to combat this is be selective and limit the television time. Liv and Maddie is in their third season, and Ant Farm is in their fourth. Clearly there's an interest in watching these. These are veteran TV shows, and not something that Disney is just, you know, testing the waters with. And so with this, we're seeing that it's very important to actually understand what the kids are watching instead of saying, well, I have some chores to do, I'm gonna go ahead and just leave them in front of Disney Channel. Also, we need to start questioning Disney's content before we simply just accept it. Because before I started this, you were thinking, well, David, don't be such a little guppy. And now we're looking at this saying, you know, I might have burned some calories watching those horrific films. And so with this, although we have a favorite Disney character, although we love our childhood with Disney, when we actually evaluate it, the things that we're seeing is that Disney is abusing laughter and abusing comedy that's influencing children in a negative way and causing them to be disrespectful because neurologically they haven't developed to the point where they actually understand the subliminal messages that they're watching. And so we need to stop accepting Disney because Disney's good, but instead we need to actually question the content that's going into these young children's minds. And so with this, it's not about just being a little guppy or being a big guppy. It's about actually processing and looking at what's going into these children's minds because the children are our future. Thank you.